It's like the Citizen Kane of 80s pop music.
Wow, that was something special.
Prepárense para conocer a los responsables de los éxitos de los 80.
This song was awesome.
Y averigüen qué pasó con los fabulosos artistas que nos dejaron con ganas de más.
We are still recognized, especially in the Northwest.
Vean quiénes aún buscan su segundo éxito.
I don't lose sleep about getting another hit record, but hey, never say never.
Y quiénes están orgullosos de haber tenido un solo éxito.
I'm Sugar Bear from EU, and I'm a one-hit wonder.
And I'm a one-hit wonder.
I'm a one-hit wonder.
Oh. Admítanlo, sin ellos los 80 hubieran sido muy aburridos. Ahora por fin se les reconocerá su mérito.
I'd rather be a one-hit wonder than a no-hit wonder.
Los 100 más grandiosos One-Hit Wonders de los 80. Su anfitrión, Judah Friedlander.
One-Hit Wonders totally rule, dude. Yeah!
Los 100 más grandiosos One-Hit Wonders de los 80.
Hey there, I'm Judah Friedlander, and we're approaching the summit this hour. We'll reveal your pick for the 80s top one-hit wonder. In other words, we're not in heaven yet, but you can see it and maybe smell it from here. So let's get right into it with number 20.
Número 20, Rockwell, Somebody's Watching Me. Con un contrato en el sello de su padre y la ayuda del desconocido amigo de la infancia Michael Jackson, Rockwell llegó al éxito en 1984 con Somebody's Watching Me.
I'm just an average man.
That you thought, like, who is this guy? How did he get access to Michael Jackson? Why is this song so good? And you realize it's the son of Berry Gordy, Motown legend.
He didn't help me. He had nothing to do with it. It was my project, and I went all the way.
When you have Michael Jackson singing your backgrounds, come on, how can you lose?
No way. See, that's why it's memorable. Michael Jackson can do no wrong in the 80s, during the time when he was black.
The best part is when Rockwell starts adopting this semi-British accent.
When I'm in the shower, I'm afraid to wash my hair. Cause I might open my eyes and find someone standing there.
Rockwell grabó otro álbum, pero pronto lo echaron de Motown y nunca más volvió a grabar.
The irony is no one's really looking for Rockwell right now, you know? He always thought someone was watching him. Apparently no one is.
Número 19, Dead or Alive, You Spin Me Round Like a Record. Antes del iPod, el CD y el cassette reinaba el vinilo y los andróginos británicos de Dead or Alive lo sabían. En 1985, Pete Burns y compañía lanzaron el vertiginoso hit You Spin Me Round Like a Record.
I love this song.
I get to know your name.
You play it, it's like a ringtone to a call you want to take.
It's a hit because it brings you to life.
The fact that it's put across like an over 6 foot Liverpudlian transvestite with an eye patch. That's entertainment, isn't it?
You Spin Me fue el primer y último éxito de la banda en los Estados Unidos, pero Pete Burns siguió en el ojo público gracias a su recordada aparición en 2006 en el Gran Hermano de Famosos del Reino Unido.
Come and have a look at my vagina.
You total.
Y por supuesto, por sus numerosas cirugías plásticas. Él dice que no quiere parecerse a una mujer, sino ser sincero consigo mismo.
There's just something really deeply rooted in the brain that you've come out wrong. I constantly wore this nylon polo neck sweater and used to pull the neck up over my face. So obviously there was something I wasn't happy with.
He had collagen inserted into his lips and they blew up enormously.
I started to develop lumps that were like hard peas.
His mouth started to leak pus and all this chemicals and stuff.
I pressed my cheek and it would go psst again. It would make this hissing sound. It was like the movie Aliens. It was squirting everywhere.
Sus problemas de salud no terminaron allí. En 2009 fue hospitalizado por insuficiencia renal.
He's a little bit of a train wreck, unfortunately. But this song, I think, captures him at his best, and that's how I'd like to remember him.
Número 18, Robbez and DJ Easy Rock, It Takes Two. Con un fabuloso sampleo del clásico Think de James Brown y Lynn Collins en 1988, Robbez and DJ Easy Rock crearon It Takes Two, un monstruo del dance rap.
To get down. I'm not internationally known,
but I'm known on the microphone.
Oh my God.
That was a damn good song.
Big.
You just gotta move your ass when that song comes on.
And all the white people go out there and they dance awful.
Oh man, if you're talking about a song that stands the test of time, your grandmama know it, your mama know it, you know it, and your kids gonna know it.
Lanzaron un par de álbumes más, pero no pudieron superar It Takes Two. Aún se los puede ver en el circuito de la vieja escuela del hip hop.
When you do shows, it seems like the record is like brand new.
As long as it's been out and for it to still be going as strong as it is, you know, it's just a wonderful feeling, and you know, I feel like we've been blessed.
No matter where you go in the world, they playing that song. And it's never old. It's not like, hey, that takes me back. It's like, no, that takes me back to right now. Turn it up.
One, two, three, get loose now.
Número 17, Men Without Hats, The Safety Dance. Estaba plagada de letras extrañas y en el video había un enano con una mandolina en una feria renacentista. Pero la canción The Safety Dance de Men Without Hats fue sensación en 1982.
Is just great. You know, some things are just great, you know, and you have no idea why. This is one of those songs.
Men Without Hats. Oh, I love him.
Like, what was a safety dance? I didn't...
That's a dance?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. They do that in the video.
In the video, they do. Is it like a box?
It's one of those guilty pleasures. And then you see the video, and you go, that's bizarre.
That video bothered me. It just gave me nightmares.
This was a weird video. It was almost like you were tripping on LSD.
La banda tuvo un éxito menor en 1987 con Pop Goes the World, pero nunca más volvieron a las listas. Hoy el cantante Iván Doroshuk es padre y vive en Canadá. Su banda graba a veces como No Hats, Beyond This Point de 2004, pero Safety Dance sigue siendo su legado y uno de los placeres más culposos de los 80.
I liked the song when it came out, but I would never let my friends know. So the only time I listened to it was in my car by myself.
We gotta take a breather before we get to the Sweet 16. Here's a peek at what's coming up.
A continuación, la imperecedera belleza de Nena.
I don't know how her bandmates could handle being in a band with such a hot lead singer.
Y Tomás Olvi, enseguecido por la ciencia y conmocionado por el éxito.
It was kind of a surprise to me because I never really set out to be a mainstream pop act.
Enseguida, los 100 más grandiosos One Hit Wonders de los 80.
At number 16, it's a lady whose beauty is known the world over, or at least in most of Germany. Today, I honor her as one of Judah's One Hit Hotties.
El hit caliente de Judas.
Nena, for years... I've dreamed of getting my hands on her Luft balloons. Plus, if you listen closely to the song, I'm pretty sure she's singing about doing it with Captain Kirk. Here's Nena and 99 Luft balloons at number 16.
Número 16, Nena, 99 Luft balloons. A comienzos de los 80, lo raro estaba de moda. Cuando Nena lanzó 99 Luft balloons, una canción cantada en alemán sobre la aniquilación nuclear, fue un éxito, desde luego.
This song's got it all. Funky bass, awesome guitar riff, German lyrics I don't understand.
Yeah, I had no idea what she was talking about, but I just know that I wanted to find out more.
Nobody knows what a Luftballoon is. Just like it's a great song, that's what. Now shut your mouth, Evan.
She's
She was sexy in that sort of like biker German leather chick way.
I had a little bit of a thing for Nina because she wore leather trousers, which is incredibly hot.
I don't know how her bandmates could handle being in a band with such a hot lead singer.
She was cute until she lifted up her arm.
She had hairy armpits. Really?
Para quienes querían entender, Nena grabó una versión en inglés, 99 Red Balloons. Lo extraño fue que solo la versión en alemán fue un éxito.
I didn't like the English version. 99 Red Balloons blew. I like the Luft Balloons.
La banda tuvo un solo éxito en los Estados Unidos y se desinfló en 1987. Ella se lanzó como solista. Casi 50 años, Nena tiene 4 hijos y sigue grabando y cantando en su tierra natal, donde fundó una escuela y todavía conserva su sensualidad.
This is a great song and the sexiness just drips off her. Fantastic.
Número 15. Divo, Whip It. Divo estaba compuesta por 5 estudiantes de arte de Ohio y ayudó a revolucionar el pop, a popularizar la nueva ola y a inventar el nerd rock con la torpe Whip It de
1980.
I remember watching that on TV, going, who are these wondrous people? I'm scared of them, but I feel I must be with them.
I used to have a flower pot hat, right?
You gotta bring this here, money. Whip that.
Hats were not flower pots, but it was based on an Art Deco ceiling fixture from my grade school. It's not too late to whip
it. No tuvieron más éxitos, pero todos sus miembros siguieron en la industria de la música. Mark Mothersbaugh se convirtió en un famoso compositor para cine y televisión.
He did the Rugrats, Royal Tenenbaums, and Nick and Nora's Infinite Playlist most recently, and tons more that I can't remember.
En 2009, Divo comenzó a grabar su primer álbum en casi 20 años y aún hacen presentaciones para sus devotos admiradores.
Still doing incredible work and still just killing every time they play.
Número 14. Big Country, In a Big Country. Los que nunca pensaron que las gaitas serían comerciales, por favor, aplaudan a In a Big Country, la epopeya de 1983 de los apuestos escoceses de Big Country.
In a Big Country by Big Country is one of my favorite 80s songs.
You can't hear this song and not bob your head like this.
Big Country, I thought, was great. The drums were so heavy and had such a unique sound, and they still put a little Scottish flavor to it.
And they wore checks, quite a lot of check flannel shirts. And it all seems to speak of a kind of lost Scotland.
Yes, we're all good country boys, you know. They live up in the hills in their little butties and sit around the campfire singing songs with their fiddles and bagpipes. That's what Big Country's all about.
In case you forgot their name, it was right in the song as well. They were Big Country, and they performed the song In a Big Country. So take a look out of here,
it doesn't fit you. En el Reino Unido son muy famosos, pero In a Big Country fue su único éxito en los Estados Unidos. En 2001, tras años de luchar contra el alcoholismo, el cantante Stuart Adamson fue encontrado muerto, aparentemente tras un suicidio. Tenía solo 43 años.
If we remembered for nothing else in that one song, then I'd be pretty happy with that.
Los demás miembros de la banda se separaron hasta que la gira del 25º aniversario los volvió a reunir en el año 2007.
Big Country should have been bigger than what they were. It's kind of sad.
It's one of those one-hit wonders that still sounds great. It's a powerful song. I love it.
Número 13. Thomas Dolby. She Blinded Me With Science. Era brillante y tenía gafas. Thomas Dolby se volvió súper famoso en 1983 con She Blinded Me With Science.
And now she's making love to me.
Who couldn't like that?
1980s. That's 80s in a time capsule, basically. So blind, don't pull around.
in the 80s, a few of us went from obscurity to our 15 minutes of stardom. It was kind of a surprise to me because I never really set out to be a mainstream pop act.
My favorite part of the song is the scientist who keeps going, "Science!
Science!
Science!
Science!"
Dr. Magnus Pike is the crazy professor in the video. I saw him once after that video, and he was very upset with me because he'd just gotten back from the USA, and walking down the streets of Manhattan, people were coming up behind him going, "Science!
She blinded me with science!"
Science fue el primer y único hit de Dolby, si no contamos miles de millones de ringtones de los teléfonos móviles. Él desarrolló esa tecnología.
In the early 90s, I quit the music business and I went to Silicon Valley and I formed a company, Beatnik, which became very successful in cell phones. Over half the world's cell phones now have Beatnik's technology in them. Now that it's a mature business, it seemed like a good time to get back into music, which was, after all, my first love.
Dolby realizó una serie de espectáculos solistas de alta tecnología y no le molesta haber tenido un solo éxito.
I think it's fine to be known for one single thing. I think there's one thing that you know about Thomas Dolby, it's that song. It stands out, you know, I think it stands the test of time.
Thank you!
Good night. Rat that hair and polish off your favorite keytar. More of the absolute greatest one-hit wonders the 80s are next.
A continuación, el regreso de Emotion.
We sat down, we had a beer, we laughed, we cried, and we made up.
Y llegamos a los primeros 10.
This is the best one-hit wonder of the 80s, hands down.
Enseguida, los 100 más grandiosos one-hit wonders de los 80. De los 80.
I'm Judah Friedlander, the world champion, and we're in a very special place right now, maybe even a sacred place. Soon, we'll be entering the temple that houses the top 10 one-hit wonders of the 80s. Come on, join me. But don't touch anything.
Número 12. Animotion, Obsession. Antes de que estuviera mal obsesionarse, Animotion alcanzó el éxito con la pegadiza Obsession de 1985.
Classic joint. It was an 80s banger.
I'll have you. Yes,
it was kind of creepy because, you know, the girl was actually stalking the dude, trying to get the dude to sleep with her.
What woman is that? And can I get her number?
Obsession fue el primer sencillo de la banda y su éxito inmediato lo sorprendió hasta a ellos.
When Obsession first hit, I was painting houses, and I heard the song on the TV in the house. And I came in and I said, "Mrs. So-and-so, can I just check out your TV for a minute?" And I said, "Hey, that's me." And she said, if you're on TV, why are you painting my house?
Tras años de diferencias creativas y de cambios en su formación, Animotion se despidió en los 90. El cantante Bill Adams compone música y hace diseño gráfico para campañas publicitarias. También tiene una familia y su hijo Charlie es un prestigioso artista independiente. La cantante Astrid Plain y el bajista Charles Ottavio se casaron y tuvieron una hija. Astrid siguió haciendo música. Es profesora de canto y actriz.
I went to acting school for a couple of years and did a couple of movies. I've done two musicals. It was so much fun.
En 2001, después de 15 años de inactividad, Bill volvió a reunir a la banda.
We sat down, we had a beer, we laughed, we cried, and we made up.
Y aunque Animotion no vuelva a tener un hit, los hijos de Bill creen que son la mejor banda.
For a while, the 80s was passé, but then it kind of came around, and sure enough, all my kids are proud of the fact that I was in Animotion and that I sang Obsession.
Número 11. Gary Numan, Cars. En 1980, el ex cantante de Tubeway Army, Gary Numan, levantó olas de este lado del Atlántico con su tecnológica y escalofriante oda al aislamiento, Cars.
It's the sound of this song that captured people's imaginations.
Gary Numan was one of the godfathers of kind of electronica.
It's just songs. It's just, I write songs and a synthesizer, not a guitar.
real synth. Da-da-da-da, here in my car.
He had that nasally voice.
In cars.
And in the video, he has tambo vision. He's playing the tambourine in the video. There's a
inside.
Inside of a tambourine. In the video, he freezes. He's like... He basically looks like a mannequin with hair.
I love Gary Newman because he genuinely seemed freaked out.
Si bien Cars fue el único éxito de Newman en los Estados Unidos, su carrera prosperó en el Reino Unido a mediados de los 80 y además se convirtió en un consumado piloto. Pero Cars seguirá siendo un tema recurrente en su vida. En 2006, Gary participó del reality británico The Race y terminó segundo después de Brian Johnson de AC/DC.
Gary Newman, Brian Johnson, and that's the great battle that we're seeing here.
Oh, it's fantastic. That's so much fun. Really enjoyed it.
Gary vive bien en Inglaterra con su esposa y sus tres hijos y por fin sus admiradores le reconocen su mérito.
He still makes records, he still tours, he still keeps it going. Even now, he sort of holds on to a very, very committed fan base. Oh, nothing seems right.
Número 10. Frankie Goes to Hollywood. Relax. En 1983, Frankie le dijo al Reino Unido relax, pero la BBC no se relajó y censuró la atrevida canción. Dos años después, Relax evadió la censura en los Estados Unidos y se convirtió en un orgásmico clásico.
Relax, one of the greatest songs ever written, people.
What makes Relax a great song is how incredibly filthy the lyrics are.
First, you're just like singing to it and relax, but when you wanna, what that boy just say?
Yeah, it's a good line.
And kids were wearing Frankie Says Relax t-shirts back then.
It has some meaning, but I don't know what it is just yet.
These kids had no idea that actually was like sexual reference.
It's a metaphor for the sexual climax achieving success, kind of. Do you understand?
Oh, I'm not sure.
Las camisetas y la banda desaparecieron a fines de la década. En 1991, el cantante Holly Johnson supo que era VIH positivo. A pesar del diagnóstico, se volvió solista y pintor y tiene un buen recuerdo de la banda. En cuanto a un encuentro...
I don't rule it out ever happening, but there aren't any plans in the near future for that to occur.
Número 9. Calla Goo Goo, Too Shy. Eran cinco chicos del Reino Unido con grandes aspiraciones y aún más altos peinados. Calla Goo Goo eran semidioses de la nueva ola en 1983 con la irresistible Too Shy.
Calla Goo Goo, good name. To be honest here, that's a good name.
You totally want to sing along even though you have no idea what you're saying.
Calla Goo Goo was tailor-made for the 80s. You've got like the big hair, you've got a little bit of the glam look.
Too Shy changed everything. You know, it was the realization of a lifelong dream for me. As a small boy, my mom was told by a local fortune teller, you have a child with you today, you will become very famous.
Too Shy fue un gran éxito, pero sorprendentemente la banda despidió al cantante Lee Moll después del lanzamiento.
I think a good manager would have said to the band, whatever you do, do not fire the popular lead singer. I mean, talk about emotional roller coaster ride, and I got through all this without therapy.
Lee Moll continuó como solista y los demás siguieron con la banda hasta su separación en 1982. Pero 23 años después, tras algunos malos comienzos, Calla Goo Goo se reunió en 2008. Desde entonces están en gira disfrutando de la nostalgia por los 80.
I'm optimistic about the future. I don't lose sleep about getting another hit record. But hey, never say never. It would be nice.
Número 8. Bow Wow Wow. I Want Candy. Malcolm McLaren, el mentor de los Sex Pistols, la descubrió en un lavadero del Reino Unido. Annabella Lewin, de 14 años, condujo a Bow Wow Wow a la infamia del pop con el cover de 1982 de The Strange Loves, I Want Candy.
I Want Candy is like a bubblegum classic. Just this excellent female performance with attitude.
Annabella Lewin was very sexy for a 15-year-old. She had the mohawk.
And the way she yelps and screeches is very agreeable. I think a lot of schoolboys had crushes on her.
Obviously, it's not just about candy. It's a euphemism.
The song creates many sensations within me. It makes me crave lollies. So sweet, you make my mouth
water. I Want Candy fue controvertida. Annabella tuvo problemas en casa al posar desnuda para la cubierta de su disco, que estaba basada en una pintura de Manette.
I posed nude at 15. My mother went ape crazy, and I had to leave pretty shortly after that.
La banda se separó un año después y Annabella continuó una humilde carrera como solista. Pero en 1997 se reunió con el bajista Leigh Gorman y desde entonces tocan juntos como Bow Wow Wow.
And at the end of the day, we're here to make music to hopefully bring some joy into people's lives.
The seven greatest one-hit wonders of the 80s lie ahead. They're even greater than the seven wonders of the world. Here's a preview.
A continuación, el número telefónico que todos sabían, pero nadie quería.
Whoever had that phone number was screwed.
Y ya llegamos a los primeros 10 acercándonos al número 1. Enseguida en los 100 más grandiosos One Hit Wonders de los 80.
But this leg. Number 7 on the 100 greatest One Hit Wonders of the 80s. There's not much left to say at this point. Just bask in their glory, my friend. Bask in their glory.
Número 7, Modern English, I Melt With You. En 1983, los amantes de la nueva ola por fin hallaron una canción para besarse. Modern English lanzó la acaramelada I Melt With You.
Modern English just really hit a perfect moment with this song. Making love to you was never second best. And it's like so romantic.
This is the best one-hit wonder of the 80s. Hands down, no question.
You always wish that you could meet the man who would, like, stop playing Nintendo to melt with you.
Is that feeling of wanting to kind of be inside someone else or merge with them? There's something so timeless and so cool about this song. I'll stop the world
and melt with you. It's just about two people coming together, really. It's definitely about making love, that's for sure.
Yeah, that's it. No, man, that's it. Oh.
La banda nunca logró superar esta canción, pero sigue sobreviviendo en películas como Valley Girl y en cientos de comerciales, hasta uno de Burger King de los 90.
Burger King chose to use I Melt With You. We didn't have any control on that. The publisher sold it. But we did have a problem with it because at the time the keyboard player was a vegan. But it was $90,000. We couldn't really complain too much, you know what I mean?
Hoy el cantante Robbie Gray vive lejos del ojo público en una campiña inglesa y tiene una tienda alejada de su aspiración a la fama del pop.
Music's not that important to me anymore. I've opened a vintage clothing store, which is just a nice little thing to do. Basically a slower pace of life.
Número 6, Tony Basil, Mickey. Tomen los pompones porque ya llegó la hora. Sí, es Mickey. Tenía un estribillo pegadizo y las mejores porristas. El hit de 1982 de Tony Basil debía ser un éxito.
Yo, everybody would dance to that song. I remember I would see thugs at parties dancing to that song.
Tony había sido actriz, cantante y coreógrafa desde comienzos de los 60, pero para Mickey se inspiró en una experiencia anterior. En su época como porrista de la preparatoria de Las Vegas.
I always knew cheerleaders was a good idea on film. So, found a song called Kitty, changed it to Mickey, and put this cheerleader chant on top of it. The record company thought it was a terrible idea. And of course, the chant is what is played over and over again.
It's infectious. It gets in your head, and you clap.
Anytime you put a girl in a cheerleader's uniform, you're off to a good start.
Yeah,
you know?
Especially with Toni Basil.
Yeah, she wasn't ugly.
No. And the pigtails thing just takes it to another level.
Mickey ocupó el primer puesto e inspiró muchas parodias, pero fue el único éxito de Basil que finalmente regresó a la danza.
We shake it and we lock it. I continue to choreograph shows and choreograph films like both Legally Blondes. I still work for Bette Midler, David Bowie, Tina Turner. So I really work a lot and I love choreographing.
Si bien Mickey no es parte de su rutina diaria, está feliz con lo que pasó.
I enjoy the success of Mickey. It really has opened doors for me. So I embrace it.
Número 5. Soft Cell, Tainted Love. En 1981, el dúo británico Soft Cell dio un toque de nueva ola a un clásico de 1964 de Gloria Jones y alcanzó el éxito con la sobrecogedora Tainted Love. Sometimes I
feel I've got to... Tainted Love is one of the best songs ever.
Bing, bing. Tainted Love is like the darkest pop song ever written.
It's kind of like mysterious.
Everybody loved that song.
It's just one of those records that's like one in a million sort of things, you know, that appeals to so many people. I give you all a boy could give you. Take my tears and that's not nearly
all. Tainted love. Tainted love. This was a defining moment for the synthesizer, and Soft Cell helped to change the sound and shape of popular music at that time. Lead singer Mark Holman was pouting, cavorting, and wearing eyeliner better than a lot of women. Ooh, men in makeup. Shock horror.
Al no tener más éxitos como Tainted Love, Soft Cell se retiró en 1984. Mark Holman se volvió cantante de cabaret. Desde entonces, su clásica canción fue versionada por Marilyn Manson, Rihanna y las Pussycat Dolls. I love you though you hurt me so. Soft Cell volvió a reunirse en 2001 y desde entonces cantan su canción. Hasta Gloria Jones se unió al grupo en una estruendosa presentación en 2007.
Everybody knows this song. Like, if you were alive in the 80s, you could have been in Russia, you could have been in the slums of the Bronx, but you knew this record.
Número 4, Tommy Two Tone, 867-5309, Jenny. Gracias al éxito de 1982 de Tommy Two Tone, hay 7 números que nunca olvidaremos. 867-5309.
It's the only phone number that everybody knows besides 911.
Whoever had that phone number was screwed.
Hey, you were just listening to the song. Your number was in there.
Every two-bit blockhead like me had to go run out immediately and dial that number. I still do it every now and then for and giggles.
That is a jam.
La banda se quedó sin Janis y se separó en 1983, tan solo un año después. El cantante Tommy Heath se mudó a Portland, Oregon, tuvo 3 hijos y es programador de informática.
Some people would consider it really mundane, but after you play guitar, it seems exotic to go in office.
Hoy Tommy regresó con la banda y Jenny sigue triunfando 20 años después. De hecho, en 2009, un DJ de Nueva Jersey que tenía el número 867-5309 lo subastó en eBay, llegando a la cifra de, atención, $186,000.
Who would want to pay thousands of dollars to have that stupid number? All you're going to do is get, like, calls from drunk frat boys all the time. It seems like it would be a nightmare.
The top three one-hit wonders of the 80s are coming up next. Don't get up to pee or anything. I'm telling you, if you have to pee your pants, do it. You'll thank me later.
Enseguida en los 100 más grandiosos One Hit Wonders de los 80. Esos One Hit Wonders de los 80.
We're up to number 3 on the countdown, and I'd like to formally recognize the video's best supporting player. She is another unsung hero of One Hit Wonderland.
Héroes no reconocidos de One Hit Wonderlandia.
It's Miss Bunty Bailey, a.k.a. the hot chick in A-ha's Take On Me video. Women have been falling in love with fictional characters for generations, but Bunty made it possible to enter their world, hold their hands, and help them escape roaming packs of Scandinavian bikers. For that, Bunty Bailey, we honor you.
Número 3. A-ha, Take On Me. Si en los 80 les gustaban los apuestos escandinavos, el trío noruego A-ha era su banda. Y los chicos llamaron la atención en 1985 con Take On Me.
Take On Me. Honestly, like, this is the theme song of the 80s.
This song deserves to be on that list, if only for the high note.
When he goes to...
I can't.
What the f*** was that?
The video for Take On Me is a sweet video with sweet effects.
Even to this day, I'm like, I can't believe they made that. That is incredible.
La banda fue nominada a un Grammy y ganó varios premios de MTV.
Take On Me.
Take On Me.
Pero luego desaparecieron de las listas de los Estados Unidos. En Europa, sin embargo, siguen siendo famosos. El último disco de A-ha salió en 2009, el mismo año que Take On Me fue elegido como la mejor canción noruega de los últimos 50 años.
I listen to A-ha all the time. I'm not even kidding you. And it just so happens that the singer of A-ha is still one of the most gorgeous men I've ever seen in my life.
Número 2. A Flacos Seagulls, I Ran So Far Away. Armados con un sonido fresco de la nueva ola y con barriles de laca, A Flock of Seagulls llegó a las listas en 1982 con I Ran So Far Away.
This is 80s all the way. This has got to be a top 5 80s song.
All I remember was this dude, he was holding one key. Never let go. He was working at one key like...
How about when he switches fingers in the middle? He's like...
I run so away.
That song was tight.
Do you think it'd be possible to get through this without making some sort of ironic crack about a flock of seagulls' hair?
It was like this huge wave that he had.
Dude's hair looked like a surfboard and
it looked like two dolphins mating.
I didn't think so.
Su cabello es recordado, pero la banda no perduró y se separó silenciosamente en 1986. Hoy el cantante Mike Score vive en Florida con su esposa y lidera una nueva banda que toca I Ran So Far Away, sobre todo porque debe hacerlo.
Everybody just wants to hear I Ran and I'm sick of it. I'll play it for them, but it's not my pride and joy anymore, you know? Everybody loves it, so they can have it.
There have been 99 possibilities for our greatest one-hit wonder of the 80s, but only one can rule them all. And here it is, the epitome of 80s awesomeness, the very best single hit made after 1979, but before 1990. Check it out.
Número 1. Dexys Midnight Runners, Come On Eileen.
Come on, Eileen.
En 1982, Dexys Midnight Runners nos presentaron una campesina, violines y varias maneras de torturar a las chicas llamadas Eileen.
Come on, Eileen. When this song came out, we were like, wow. Come on, Eileen. This might be the best song ever made.
This is not just a one-hit wonder from a certain area. This is one of the great recordings of all time.
Even if you've never heard it, you automatically feel like you know it.
You can't help but get into it. You've got no choice.
That song has such a rousing chorus, and everybody feels Irish when they sing it.
You know, Dexys Midnight Runners pioneered the look of the denim overalls with the bandana.
It's not that much of an image or anything. It's just clothes that we wear, you know. It's just like, it's really no big deal at all, you know.
En el Reino Unido tuvieron otros éxitos, pero Eileen fue el único hit de la banda en los Estados Unidos. En 1986, Kevin Rowland se hartó. Abandonó la banda, continuó como solista y se convirtió en un ícono del rock europeo.
Kevin Rowland, you know, is a sort of youth hero in the 80s. And he's a great musician, quite a tortured guy.
En 2003, la banda se reunió brevemente para una exitosa gira y hoy Rowland vive tranquilo en Inglaterra y hace nueva música. ¿Y Eileen? Aún no podemos quitárnosla de la cabeza.
I feel pretty lousy about being a one-hit wonder in the US, actually. You know, because we were more than that. But I'm grateful for the royalties. There you go, that's life. That's a wrap, 80s fans. Those were the decade's 100 greatest one-hit wonders. I'm Judah Friedlander, the world champion, reminding you, if you get just one shot, take it. You could be on this countdown in 2025. Fingers crossed.